my name is Mackenzie Barrows. I'm a seventh semester nursing student, and today is February 15th, around 11:30 in the morning, and I'm going to be demonstrating NG tube insertion, meds per tube, and removal of NG tube. So whenever I would go into my patient's room, I would make sure that I had all my supplies gathered. I would walk in and perform hand hygiene and introduce myself to the patient and check two patient identifiers. I would double check my physician's order, and then I would go ahead and let them know that this is going to be an uncomfortable procedure, and I would have my pen light, and I would check both nares to see which nostril is more patent that I could go down with easier access. So I'm going to go ahead and pick his right side here. So I'm going to don on a pair of clean gloves. And make sure I already had my tape and everything ready to go. And I'm going to measure the tube by going from nose to ear, and then from ear to xiphoid process. And then I will mark that with a piece of tape. I'm going to go ahead and spray my tube with lube about 4 inches. And then I'm going to have a bucket for any residual that possibly comes up. And I also have a towel in case anything messy comes up. So I'm going to have him in high Fowler's position with his head all the way placed back, hyperextended. And I'm going to go ahead and insert. And as soon as he starts to cough, I'm going to have him tilt forward and start taking a drink of water to help it pass. And I'm going to continue on down until I meet resistance. So then, since I'm at my marker and I've met resistance, I'm going to go ahead and take it down. Now to check placement. I'm going to pull up 20 mLs of air. I'm going to place my stethoscope over his abdomen and push it and listen for a swishing sound. I heard a swishing sound, so I'm going to say that we're in the right area. My patient's not coughing, so I don't think that it's in his lungs. And to confirm, we could do an x-ray to check the placement for sure. From there, I'm going to go ahead and check the residual that comes out of the tube just in case. And then before I go ahead and do the my meds. I'm going to check. We're all good. So I'm going to go ahead and drop my meds. I've gone ahead and crushed my meds. I'm going to check compatibility, and I'm going to have my meds in with some water. Before that, I'm going to go ahead and pull up 20 mLs of water. I'm going to pull up my med. that mid. And I'm going to flush. With 20. And then my next mid. If these were one right after another, I wouldn't have to go ahead and flush in between every mid. But since I'm going to act like these are two different times, I'm going to go ahead and do my 20 mls again. Prior. And then pull up my mid. And then flush with 20 more. So now that all of our mids are all done, I'm going to go ahead and go on removing. So before removal, I can also check residual, and then I'm going to go ahead and flush with 20 more mls. Let them know that this is going to be slightly uncomfortable, but to take a deep breath. And then I'm just going to pull it out in one swoosh. And that would be it. So then I would go ahead and document how my patient handled the procedures both times. And I would remove my gloves and perform hand hygiene. And that's all.